Welcome to DIY Solar and Wind. Today I want to discuss the battery cables for your off-grid system. You want the 4-aught wire. It's basically the welding cable. 4-aught welding. These are the lugs. This is the route you don't want to go, okay? If you get 12 of these, you can make 6 cables. These alone are $120. Plus, oh my god, I just watched a marathon of battery terminals. People are getting copper. Okay, you get a copper pipe, a couple feet long, and you only need a little piece. You're going to flatten this part out. You're going to drill a hole in it. Okay? So you can start making this $10 piece. Do I have to get really close? This 10-50 lug for a couple pennies. Okay? Do yourself a favor. Don't get fancy. Because I'm concerned it's going to cost me $1,000 before I expire. So yeah, I got a dozen. This is gonna be 6 cables. It's ridiculous. Thank you, YouTube. So I can learn and I can teach everybody else on my videos. And if you want to go big, Brian G. Johnson, so you can grow your YouTube channel. I'm not a sponsor of any of this. YouTube marketing power. They're just for looks. I never read them. I do a little web design. I do a lot of social marketing. I have 17,000 people on my network. This YouTube is all brand new. It's only been 7 months. It is extremely difficult to get people to come over from Facebook to YouTube. They don't like it. So I thought YouTube was going to grow exponentially faster than what it has. Surprise. So this is the 4-aught cable. I have another set of these. These are 25 foot each. But the 100 feet, both red and black, are $434. They were on sale. I just got the whole thing. It was all that was at Menards. So, now I have to go get some copper tubing because this, there's only going to be a few of these that I'm going to make. And these are going to be gone. I'm not spending $20 plus cable. That's probably $50 per each little cable if it's this long, because this wire is expensive. Do yourself a favor. Go get some copper tubing that fits over your 4-aught. I don't know what that is, but half inch maybe. I'll figure it out. I will go straight up to my do-it center. I make them do a lot of these gadgets. They help me to build the solar pool heater and all the different sizes to go from the garden hose to the 1¼-inch sump pump hose that heats the pool. They're pretty talented people. They will know what size of copper wire that will be to go on the 4-aught cable. So, for all you DIYers out there that want to do solar, when you get the huge batteries, or even the little batteries, you got to make your own battery lugs, okay? Just get over it, and you got to use solder. All the experts are saying, yeah, even if you crimp it, you have to have solder. Because the only crimp that's good is the expensive crimpers. So if you're crimping your cables, making it look professional, it could be 3 or 4 years. There's an issue inside, is what it sounds like. So solder it in there, and you're all good, with or without a crimp. Solder it in. So my crimpers will be here December 6th, approximately. So if I get ahead and start doing this and soldering, I won't need the crimpers, is what it sounds like. But yeah, some of them are crimping, then soldering. So just letting you know, there's a few options out there. I'm not an expert by no means, but 8 years of being grid tied was extremely, it was a whole lot easier. So going off grid was definitely a challenge, and I know I can overcome this. Thanks to all my YouTube buddies out there that's steering me straight. Thank you, everybody. One day at a time, we're going to learn. We're going to get through this until the house is off-grid and a different house, homesteading. That'd be nice to have a new home by springtime anyway. Then I can start growing my own food. All right, have a nice sunny day.